Las puertas de la iglesia rodeadas de barricas te encuentras sin sendera. Vestidas con acero puro, unas florecidas en primavera.
Mother, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, we are gathered here this morning to celebrate the 15th anniversary, 13th birthday of these girls, Chelsea, Kelly, Yarcy, Lisbeth, and Isabel. Estamos aquí reunidos para festejar el 15 aniversario de vida de estas hermanas nuestras que vienen a dar gracias a Dios por estos 15 años de vida que les ha dado, y nosotros estamos también aquí para ser testigos de esta experiencia en su vida en la que ellas pues dejan atrás en una cierta manera la infancia, la niñez, para convertirse en mujeres, para ser jóvenes adultas dentro de poco. Entonces, we hope of these girls that they are passing from the childhood to the young adult life soon. With your support, they continue fulfilling their mission in their lives. And now, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Señor Dios, de quien todo bien procede, escucha nuestras súplicas y concédenos que, comprendiendo por inspiración tuya lo que es recto, eso mismo bajo tu guía lo hagamos realidad. Por nuestro Señor Jesucristo, que vive y reina contigo en la unidad del Espíritu Santo y es Dios por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
Pueden sentarse para escucharlo.
Lectura del libro del profeta Jeremías. En tiempo de Josías, el Señor me dirigió estas palabras. Desde antes de formarte en el seno materno, te conozco. Desde antes de que nacieras, te consagré profeta para las naciones. Yo les contesté, pero Señor mío, yo no sé expresarme, porque apenas soy un muchacho. El Señor me dijo, no digas que eres un muchacho, pues dirás a donde yo te envíe y dirás lo que yo te mandé. No tengas miedo, porque yo estoy contigo para protegerte. Palabra del Señor. El Señor extendió entonces su brazo, con su mano secó la boca y me dijo: Desde hoy pongo mis palabras en tu boca y te doy autoridad sobre los pueblos y reyes, para que arranques y derribes, para que destruyas y deshagas, para que edifiques y plantifiques. Palabra de Dios.
Because my brothers and friends,
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It's not jealous. Love is not pompous. It's not envious. It's not rude. It's not seeking self-interest. It's not quick-tempered. It does not prove rude or angry. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, they will be brought to nothing.
Le dará el trono de su antepasado David. gobernará por siempre al pueblo de Jacob y su reinado no terminará jamás. María entonces dijo al ángel: ¿Cómo puede ser eso si yo soy virgen? Contestó el ángel: El Espíritu Santo descenderá sobre ti y el poder del Altísimo te cubrirá con su sombra. Por eso el niño santo que nacerá de ti será llamado Hijo de Dios. También tu pariente Isabel está esperando un hijo en su vejez, y aunque no podía tener familia, se encuentra ya en el sexto mes del embarazo. Para Dios nada es imposible. Dijo María: Yo soy la servidora del Señor, hágase en mí tal como has dicho. Después la dejó el ángel. Palabra del Señor. Pueden sentarse para escuchar. Kevin Harrison is bed, and some of you are here today to say thank you to God with all your relatives. And the main message that I have for you in this homily, first of all, I want to take this from the second reading. When we heard love is patient, el amor es paciente. Ustedes están en una edad en la que tal vez todo lo quieren y todo lo quieren alcanzar ya. Sí. Rápido. Everybody wants at this age to have everything fast, soon. But the good things, they have. Las buenas cosas necesitan tiempo. It's very important for you to wait, to be patient, and to be able to live this stage in your life, patient. You are right now in high school. And soon, in a couple of years, or a bit more, you will be in. And everything will be different for them, as is different now, that they are consecrating their lives to God in their 15 years anniversary before the 15th birthday. Todo será distinto como lo es ahora. Están consagrando su vida a Dios en estos 15 años de vida que Dios les ha dado. Será distinto cuando lleguen a esos 18 años. Pero es importante que disfruten esta etapa de su vida, en la que están con sus padres, y si Dios les dio la bendición de tener a sus hermanos también. Son momentos muy bonitos que deben aprovechar en familia. Son 3 años más. We know that in this culture where we live, most of the teenagers, they left to go to college and they reach 18 years old in their life. And then after that, they got to college with great hope, with hope that they finish college, and then they have the first job. We wish that that job can be here. Close to us, but sometimes those jobs are found far away in other states and in some cases in other countries. So why do we live a life where you want to be like a king when you are already 50? Take your time. Take your time. Nobody's pushing you to be and to act as an adult yet. But if you wish to be treated like that, You have to behave like that. Nadie les está forzando a ser adultas, pero si ustedes quieren ser tratadas como adultas, así es como deben de actuar entonces. For that reason, I am inviting you to live day by day, and if you are in your 50s, try to be faithful to your parents, to your siblings, to be faithful to yourself, to God. And try to enjoy each moment that you have in your life again with your family. These years that you have to come before you leave college will not be come back. And also for you, parents, friends, relatives, it's muy importante que ustedes también disfruten esta experiencia, estos años que tienen con sus hijas, antes de que ellas salgan de su hogar. Disfrútenlas, síganlas guiando, y esperemos ellas en este día con amor, porque de tal forma que ellas aprenden a ser buenas hijas, ustedes también están aprendiendo a ser buenos padres. Nadie les ha enseñado cómo ser los mejores papás. Sin embargo, día a día ustedes se esfuerzan con mucho amor a hacerlo. Esperemos sus hijas sepan reconocer ese esfuerzo que ustedes hacen por proveer a ellas y a sus hijos de lo que necesitan. Y de la misma manera, les pido a ustedes que sus padres les perdonen los errores que cometen, porque nadie somos perfectos. Todos cometemos errores. Solo Dios es perfecto, solo su Santísima Madre, todos los demás a veces cometemos errores. Entonces, de la misma manera en que sus padres les perdonen, sepan ustedes perdonar cuando sus padres se equivocan. Es muy importante el perdón, que haya reconciliación, que haya paz, que no haya división. Lo que quiere el maligno en nuestras vidas es to create division. The evil wants family divided, because if family is divided, he knows already that he has conquered that family. For that reason, it is very important for all of us to keep our family together, to learn to pray together, to stay together in the good and in the bad. Do not let evil to come in your family and take your children, take your parents. You that are aware about now how evil works, pray for your parents, pray for your siblings, that all of them can be protected by God and not be punished by people. I can imagine that you are seeing your life in the future with so many big dreams. I want to ask that all of those beautiful big dreams that you have in your heart and in your mind, and all those good thoughts that you have, put those in an oven, write those. And then, when you become discouraged, go to that notebook, read those big dreams that you have, those good thoughts that you have, and help yourself to walk forward, and with God's grace, that you may reach those good and beautiful dreams. Because who doesn't have beautiful and big dreams when we are young? All of us, we have it. All of us. And sometimes when we become older and older, and maybe the life that we have, the experiences that we have, putting us some kind of discouragement, some kind of bitterness in our life, lead us to lose hope, and then
died for us.
And with him,
we can conquer everything. We can reach everything.
And always remember all of those beautiful victories. You have to consider not just the pain in yourself. Piensen también en el bien de los demás.
Cualquier vocación a la que Dios les llame
va a ser una vocación en la que lo que ustedes hagan va a ser para el servicio de la comunidad. ¿Ustedes han pensado en qué les gustaría hacer en el futuro? ¿Han pensado en eso? ¿Qué profesión les gustaría? ¿Qué les gustaría estudiar? ¿Lo han pensado? ¿Has pensado eso? ¿No? ¿No tienes esa idea? ¿Ninguna idea en tu caso? Entonces, sí, ¿qué te gustaría estudiar? ¿Qué?
Sí.
Tecnología. Software.
¿Lo has pensado?
Imagínense, él ha pensado software.
Todos nosotros tenemos muchas veces en nuestras manos
nuestro teléfono. Para que esto funcione, hay mucha gente detrás, where and those people as her,
they were studying one point in their life, technology, software. And thanks to them, we can enjoy this technology
because they reach their dream. And they are helping through their jobs to other people.
But now that she mentioned this, and I have this in my hands, I want to also warn you. We have to use that technology wisely. Because this can be used for good or for bad.
And I don't want to give here wide explanations. But it's very important that this device is helping you to do bad in your life, put his body aside, not in your room, not in your cave, not in between you and your spouse, or the adults, those who are married, your children. Try to be wise how to use it, because this can be something so good. Example, I use this to learn English. I like to learn English. Or can be used for something bad. For example,
I know many of you may have Facebook. And Facebook is something that can be used for good or for bad.
There's people that they use that for creating bullying in others. And we have to be able to refrain ourselves to use technology for to do that, for to create evils, and to put down brothers and sisters that are close to us, or to put down themselves.
I know people that when their parents take away their phones, they go down. And I ask them, why are you so down now? Well, I have been not using the phone for 1 week. My mom picked up the phone for me, and I am not able to use it. And I asked, little boy, what you did?
Well, I was using the phone in a bad way.
And my mother just learned that.
No. And I asked him, do you think she did wrong or good? And he said, well, she did good. Because she wanted to prevent me that I go further and I can hurt more this person. So it's very important that whatever in the future all of you vocation you receive, try to think in the commonwealth and how you will be serving others. For example, today you have here the photographers, they are working and they are serving the community. They are serving you today. Thanks to them, you have the
products, you will be happy to be you. Then when you go to your park, probably you will be having a restaurant or place where you rent a piece of room and have meals. Somebody's cooking those meals for you. So it's very important, brothers and sisters, que nosotros empecemos a pensar en cómo lo que hacemos ayuda para el bien de los demás. Todo lo que hacemos puede ayudar al bien de los demás.
Y muchas veces no lo vemos así.
Pensamos en nosotros mismos y nos quedamos ahí. We have to go out of our shell and to start thinking, how can I do, in what ways, benefit others? How I can do this better for God's glory? How I can improve what I do in my job to do this in a better way? Sometimes we can be discouraged if we are not able to wish. But don't put your heart on money. Money is important, but it's not the main thing that can move us. Need to be God. And sometimes we put money and then God. You have to do it first God and then other things. Always God first. Always. Let us continue with our Mass, and now we will be doing the rite of the 15th, and I want to start with a renewal of baptism. I would like to ask Kelly Jersey, Lisbeth, and Isabel to stand up, please. Kelly, Garrison, Lisbeth, and Isabel, when you were an infant, your parents and godparents brought you to the waters of baptism to initiate you in the new life of our Savior Jesus Christ. At that time, they made a profession of faith for you and in your name in the same faith which now brings you to this altar. Therefore, the Catholic Church now asks you renew and affirm the same commitment, faith, of your own free will and conviction. And so, Kelly, Garrison, Lisbeth, and Samuel, do you renounce sins so that you may live in the freedom of a daughter of God? Do you renounce the attraction of evil so that sin will not enslave you? Do you renounce Satan, father and author of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the dead, and in eternal life? God, the all-powerful Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and forgiven all our sins, may also keep you faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ forever and ever. Amen. And then can you continue with the dedication to Christ? Kelly Harrison is dead and is alone. May God, who has begun things good work in you, bring it to completion. Amen. And I would like to invite all those who are present in the signals to come forward as you make your proposal. What did you feel like when you held her for the first time? ¿Qué sintieron cuando la tuvieron la primera vez en sus brazos? Mucha emoción. Miedo. ¿Algún sentimiento alguien más quiere compartir? Felicidad. What were her first words? ¿Cuáles fueron las primeras palabras que ella dijo que ustedes recuerden? We believe that God's come into them in a special way, a baptism. The seed of the spiritual life is planted, which prepared them for a life as a disciple of Jesus. Ahora vamos a presentar the baptismal certificate, porque nosotros creemos que Dios vino dentro de ellas de una manera especial en el bautismo, y esa semilla espiritual de vida fue plantada, la cual las prepara a ellas para ser discípulas de Jesús. Pueden pasar a dejar sus certificados. Kelly Harrison is dead and is alone. You have received the life of Christ and have given the grace to walk always as children of life. May you keep the flame of faith alive in your hearts. Now we present the baptism candle. Presentamos ahora la vela de bautismo que ustedes recibieron, en la cual recibieron la luz de Cristo y les ha sido dada para la gracia para caminar siempre como hijos de la luz. Y ustedes puedan permanecer siempre en esta flama de fe viva en sus corazones. Pueden presentar a la tela. Kelly Harrison is dead and is alone. You became a new creation and were clothed in a white garment. Now with God's grace, you will be able to bring the dignity that white garment represents to a heaven and everlasting life. Ahora presentamos las vestiduras blancas que recibieron en el bautismo, en las cuales ustedes fueron creadas las una nueva creación y vestidas con estas vestiduras blancas, ahora, con la gracia de Dios, ustedes serán capaces de llevar la dignidad que estas vestiduras blancas representan al cielo y a la vida eterna. Presentamos ahora las vestiduras blancas. Now we have the religious medal. The medal is an expression of your faith. You are all placed under the protection of the saint represented by the image on the medal. Ahora tenemos la medalla religiosa. Esta es una expresión de su fe y está colocada bajo la protección del santo que representa la imagen que se encuentra en la medalla. Pueden ponerlo en las medallas. The next symbol is the Bible that represents your commitment to follow the word of God and to take God's word to others. May His words give you strength, confidence, courage, and consolation through your lives. Ahora vamos a presentar la Biblia, que representa su compromiso a seguir la palabra de Dios y a tomar la palabra y a llevar la palabra de Dios a otros. También que las palabras de Dios les dé la fortaleza, confianza, el valor y la consolación a través de sus vidas. El siguiente símbolo es el rosario. El rosario es un signo de oración y devoción a nuestra Santísima Madre, la Virgen María, Madre de Dios, para que ella pueda interceder como buena madre por ustedes siempre en su vida. We present now the rosario. Siempre las flores en cualquier celebración son símbolo de nueva vida. Ahora voy a bendecir estos artículos que han presentado. Bless, O Lord, these items which we bless in your name, may they be a source of joy for them on their pilgrimage to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Now I want to invite the parents to come up and to bless the daughters. Thank you. Now we have presentation of flowers to the Blessed Virgin Mother. Invoquemos con confianza, hermanos y hermanas, a Dios Padre Todopoderoso, y pidamos por Jesucristo, tu Hijo y nuestro Señor, que derrame los dones de su bondad sobre Kelly, Yarsin, Esther, Anisabel, y sobre nosotros.
Puedan disfrutar la visión de Dios en el cielo. Rogamos al Señor.
our community, that they may experience God's love for them and those around them, respond to their needs. We pray to the Lord.
For
todos los fieles para que descansen en paz, especialmente Vicente Rodríguez y Juan Luis Ayala. Rogamos al Señor.
Te rogamos, Señor. Escucha, Padre Celestial, con amor las oraciones de tu familia, que ponen en ti su confianza. Ayúdala para que se vea libre de todo mal y enriquecida con toda clase de bienes. Te lo pedimos por Cristo nuestro Señor. Amén.
Pueden sentarse. Cantemos el número 686 del libro de Abra, Here I Am, Lord, número 686. Listo en singing number 686 of the Gallery Book, Here I Am, Lord, number 686.
It is truly right and just, salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare the glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages,
we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, my Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
venimos de tener presente en casa, pero una palabra tuya avanzará para sanarme. Dear brothers and sisters, we have come to the culmination of our celebration today, the reception of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. I would like to remind everyone that this is only for Catholics and for those Catholics who have prepared themselves according to the traditional rites of the Church. If you are a Catholic who is not disposed to receive today, or if you are a non-Catholic, you have the options. You can prayerfully remain in the pews or come forward, placing your arms across your chest to indicate that you would like to receive a blessing. I ask that we show due respect and reverence to the body and blood of Christ, our Lord, as we continue to work towards becoming truly one life in prayer. Hermanos y hermanas, hemos llegado al momento culmen de nuestra celebración de hoy, la recepción del cuerpo y la sangre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Y quiero recordarles a todos que esto es nada más para católicos, y aquellos católicos que se han preparado según los ritos de la Iglesia. Si usted es un católico que no está dispuesto a recibir hoy el cuerpo de Cristo, o si no es católico, tiene dos opciones. Se puede quedar piadosamente en la banca o pasar al frente con sus brazos cruzados a través de su pecho para indicar que quiere recibir una bendición. Les pido que muestren respeto y reverencia al cuerpo y la sangre de Cristo nuestro Señor, así como seguimos trabajando para llegar a ser realmente uno como mujer. We thank you for Kelly, Yarsin, Lisbeth, and Isabel, who today celebrate their 15th birthday. Bless them with your love and friendship, that they may grow in wisdom, knowledge, and grace. May they love their family always and be faithful to their friends. Grant this to Christ our Lord. And to all who are gathered here today to celebrate the 15th birthday, may the Lord give you the joy of His Spirit and the blessing of His kingdom through His Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. May the blessing of the Father and